Lord, let it be.
Let's try it again.
Just a closer walk with thee. Granted, Jesus is my plea.
Yeah. all that we can get. God's word be like,
stayed on him and came out to worship.
Amen.
We're at that point in time when we want to go to the Lord in prayer once again. We invite you to come to the altar as we come for corporate prayer. If you choose to stay in your seat, as I often do, if you choose to get on your knees, whatever your choice, whatever makes you comfortable as we praise our Lord, we invite you to do.
Yes.
simply saying the word that we don't say enough, Lord, and that's just thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for your many blessings. Thank you. As the kids say, as they mimic us, thank you, Lord, for waking us up this morning. Thank you, Lord, for starting us on our way. Thank you, Lord, for loving us so much that you sent your Son to reopen the doors of salvation that we might spend in eternity with you. Thank you, Lord, your Father. Thank you, Lord, for carrying us all through this last week and bringing us thus far where we find ourselves in your house. Right now, at this time, Father, we thank you for our men and women in service, those who have gone away and have come back sick. Just yesterday, Lord, and the day before, and 3 days before that, they had the ongoing celebrations of those who passed away on the ship, and we pray, Lord, that they knew you and are now in your presence. So, Lord, we thank you for those who have returned to us, those that are here now, that could have not been, but yet your blessing overlooking and keeping them safe. We thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Father, we would be remiss if we didn't take a moment to simply thank you for the pastor of this church.
Yes.
Your shepherd, your under shepherd, and his wife continue to lift them up. Continue to keep your armor of protection.
Yes. Yes.
Hold them close to your bosom. Then, Father, we just thank you.
And as your vision is brought forth,
thank you.
Fall upon open ears, open eyes, and open hearts.
Yes.
So that we move forward praising your name. Then, Father, just pause for a moment to remember our sick and shattered.
Yes.
All of those who would love to be with us. And unfortunately, cannot, for whatever the reason, they are not here. We ask, Lord, that in the quietness of the midnight hour, when they find themselves in their own prayer closets, that you would reveal yourself to them in the form of your Holy Spirit. Touch them. Be with them. Lift them up. Let them know that though they are not here in this place, that you are there in their place. Because like you said, Lord, that you would never leave us. No sin. And we know it to be true, Lord, because you said it.
Yes,
Lord. We also know that the good book tells us and teaches us in so many ways that our Lord cannot lie. And so we believe that which you have written. We believe that which you have said.
Yes.
Father, we would simply ask that you would cause us to live our lives as if we believe, because we do.
Yes.
And let someone else see us and say, what is it that you have? What is it that lifts you up when you should be down? What is it that allows you to smile when you should be crying? What is it when you do cry, they seem to be tears of joy? What is it? What is it? And we can simply say to our Lord and Savior Jesus, give us an opportunity, Lord, to lift you up. Lift you up, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Again, we simply say
thank you.
Father, we ask that you would look through our list that we have.
Yes, thank you.
The prayer needs that are listed, Lord. We won't read them all now, but you know the need of each and every one of them.
Yes, Lord.
We would ask that you would just bless them, Lord, individually.
Right now, Lord, right now.
Hold us together.
Yes.
Hold our nations together.
Yes.
Be with those now, Lord, who are traveling on the highways and byways and trying to get back.
Yes,
to their homes. Today is a great day of travel.
Yes,
Father, we pray especially for, if you'd allow me to indulge myself, my own family is coming back from Northern California and have to go through the Santa Barbara fires, and pray that you would be with them and keep them safe as they go all the way around, whatever it takes to get back to this place.
Yes,
and then, Father, we would ask that as we move from this place to our work, from this place to our school, from this place to our retirement, from this place into the world, that we continue to be in the world but not of the world, that we continue to be a beacon of light for you, Lord. As someone has already said, we might be the only Bible that they ever see. That letter written by you to be read by the world, let them read, Lord.
Let them reflect what you would have them to see. Allow us to lift you up, that you might draw men unto you. For we know that it is your desire that none should be lost. And how can they hear your word if we do not take it into your word? Help us, Lord, not to just preach the gospel, but to live the gospel.
Yes, Lord.
Let us be that which you have called us to be. And in it we shall give you the glory and the praise.
Hallelujah.
And his children will hear to say, amen.
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 And may God bless you and keep you in the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name.
Thank you.
like, but listen.